The CDC has identified a case of coronavirus in Washington state, the Wuhan strain of this. If you remember SARS, that affected GDP, travel-related effects. Have you been briefed by the CDC?
I have.
Are the words about a pandemic at this point?
No, we're not at all, and we have it totally under control. It's one person coming in from China, and we have it under control. It's going to be just fine.
On the coronavirus outbreak in China, my administration will take all necessary steps to safeguard our citizens from this threat.
Now, the virus that we're talking about having to do, you know, a lot of people think that goes away in April with the heat.
Because of all we've done, the risk to the American people remains very low.
Anybody right now and yesterday, anybody that needs a test gets a test. They're there. They have the tests. And the tests are beautiful. Anybody that needs a test gets a test.
I spoke with President Xi. We had a great talk. He's working very hard, I have to say. He's working very, very hard. And if you can count on the reports coming out of China, that spread has gone down quite a bit. The infection seems to have gone down over the last 2 days.
Say the term again.
A person at the White House used the term kung flu. My question is, do you think that's wrong, kung flu? And do you think using the term Chinese virus, that puts Asian Americans at risk, that people might target them?
No, not at all. I think they probably would agree with it 100%. It comes from China. There's nothing not to agree. Okay, how about... Right, and then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or almost a cleaning? Because you see it gets in the lungs and it does a tremendous number in the lungs. So it'd be interesting to check that. So that you're going to have to use medical doctors with. But it sounds interesting to me.
Who's in charge of that operation, Warp Speed?
We have... You know who's in charge of it, honestly? I am. I'll tell you, I'm really in charge of it. I could say somebody else.
We're prepared and we're doing a great job with it, and it will go away. Just stay calm, it will go away. I want every American to be prepared for the hard days that lie ahead. We're going to go through a very tough 2 weeks. Because of all we've done, the risk to the American people remains very low. It's absolutely critical for the American people to follow the guidelines for the next 30 days. It's a matter of life and death, frankly. It's a matter of life and death.
With the flu, on average, we lose from 26,000 to 78,000 people a year, even more than that in some cases, some years. We haven't lost anybody yet.
If we can hold that down, as we're saying, to 100,000, it's a horrible number. Maybe even less, but to 100,000. So we have between 100 and 200,000. We all together have done a very good job.
But the Democrat policy of open borders is a direct threat to the health and well-being of all Americans. Now you see it with the coronavirus. You see it. You see it with the coronavirus.
We must put politics aside, stop the partisanship, and unify together as one nation and one family.
Now, the virus that we're talking about having to do, you know, a lot of people think that goes away in April with the heat.
But they think August, could be July, could be longer than that.
We're considering a national emergency declaration that would allow states and local governments to cap FEMA.
I don't think you'll need that because I really think we're in, you know, extremely good shape. Today, I am officially declaring a national emergency. Two very big words. When you have 15 people, and the 15 within a couple of days is going to be down to close to zero, that's a pretty good job we've done.
I've been watching them bring in trailer trucks, freezer trucks. They're freezer trucks because they can't handle the bodies. There's so many of them.
We have done an incredible job. We're going to continue. It's going to disappear. One day it's like a miracle. It will disappear. People were saying, well, let's just ride it out. This is not to be written out, because then you would have been looking at potentially 2.2 million people or more. 2.2 million people in a relatively short period of time.
The CDC said yesterday that they believe it's inevitable that the virus will spread in the United States, and it's not a question of if, but when. Do you agree with that assessment?
Well, I don't think it's inevitable. It probably will. It possibly will.
The modeling estimates that the peak in death rate is likely to hit in 2 weeks. So, I'll say it again. The peak, the highest point of death rate, remember this, is likely to hit in 2 weeks.
We'll have tremendous rallies, and we're doing very well, and we've done a fantastic job with respect to that subject on the virus.
We have a big one in Tampa, all sold out. We have over 100,000 requests for tickets, but I think we'll probably not do it because people would say it's better to not do.
Spoke to the White House doctor, terrific guy, talented guy. He said he sees no reason to do it. There's no symptoms, no anything.
I also took the test last night, yeah. And I decided I should, based on the press conference yesterday, people were asking, did I take the test?
But anybody that needs a test can have a test. They're all set.
So if your doctor doesn't think you need it, don't get the test. Don't get the test. I think it's very important. Not everybody should run out and get the test.
Dr. Fauci said earlier this week that the lag in testing was, in fact, a failing. Do you take responsibility for that? And when can you guarantee that every single American who needs a test will be able to have a test? What's the date of that?
Yeah, no, I don't take responsibility at all. We have now tested with the best test far more than anybody else. When I say anybody else, I'm talking about other countries. No country is even close.
Late last night, I had a very good talk with President Xi, and we talked about mostly about the coronavirus. They're working really hard, and I think they're doing a very professional job.
But I'm a little upset with China, I'll be honest with you, because as much as I like President Xi and as much as I respect the country, and they should have told us about this.
UK basically has been, it's got the border, it's got very strong borders. And they're doing a very good job. They don't have very much infection at this point, and hopefully they'll keep it that way.
All of a sudden, they went hard the other way because they started seeing things that weren't good. So they were, you know, they put themselves in a little bit of a problem. Now, Boris tested positive, and I hear he's, I hope he's going to be fine.